from the derailment, there was a separation in the airline, yes.
So that there must have been a car that derailed, which forced the emergency brakes.
Yes, from the derailment. From the derailment, course, the air hoses were separated somewhere in the train line, and that causes an emergency brake application.
So they did not, nobody actually did a manual emergency
At this time, there's no evidence of that yet. But we're still doing downloads of the event recorders.
Do you have any information that the presence of these two young ladies on the ledge caused this derailment?
I don't have it. Let me emphasize again. We're looking at every single aspect of this occurrence, okay? Rail, track, witness statements, event recorders, video equipment, all this is going to be looked at in depth to find the information that we need to determine cause and those kinds of things.
Can you say now whether you can make that determination with the presence of those two young ladies?
It's still just the first day. We're still doing fact gathering, okay? Still working with the FRA and other authorities to gather that data and to sift through and find out what's factual and what we have.
How many cars have you righted and reloaded, and how long do you expect this operation to take? How long will you expect your reload?
These cars were coal cars, and a lot of them dumped their loads. We're working with bridges, so most of these cars are being removed empty. Okay, it is quite a long process. It's in a very difficult area, so they're taking utmost care for safety to remove the cars very carefully, and it is a very slow process. And I do not have details exactly on how long that'll take.
Has that event recorder been viewed yet?
The event recorder from the locomotives has been downloaded, and we're currently doing an evaluation of that download now. All right.
Are the video, perhaps you said you covered some of the video that you were doing, what progress has it made with that in determining if, in fact, the engineer snapped the springs to avoid the young man?
The video information, the components that we've taken from the train will be taken to Washington, D.C., to our laboratory there, to be downloaded and evaluated.
I know it's too early to know exactly what happened, but what are the preliminary reports? How did it happen?
Right now, we're in the fact gathering. We're gathering the evidence and the information. We're not going to speculate ever, okay? There's tons of information from the downloads. There's tons of information from the inspections we've done on the cars. We have a track expert up there looking at track. So all this information right now is being gathered. There's quite a lot of information, which is why it takes some time. So again, this is day one.
For clarification's sake, I know earlier it was reported that the two women were in fact struck by the train. Is that the case or not?
That's not information that I can put forth right now. There might be some information available from the county authorities, but all of this is stuff we're still looking at. Information we're still looking at.
Emergency brake, you said, deployed after the initial derailment.
Let's not make that tough of a determination. We had an emergency brake application, which generally shows that there's been a break in the airline somewhere in the train, a separation, okay? Each of these cars have air hoses and air systems on them. When there's a break in the connection or a break in a brake pipe, either from the derailment forces or whatever it may be, that will cause the trains to go to an emergency braking.
What can you tell us about the engineer, sir? How long has it been? Do you have any information about the engineer?
The only information I have right now that I know for sure is we had an engineer, a conductor, and a trainee engineer. And that's all I can tell you right now.
Can you talk about the process as far as what they have to do? They have to write each car, clear the call out. What's the process? What are the steps involved with?
Well, the first step is that we complete all of our investigations, okay, that we have going on. I said I had 9 people here. Critical to this would be the track, of course, the components, the equipment. That's looking at all the wheels. It's looking at all the cars, all the trucks, all the assemblies. It's quite involved. It's looking at the information in the event recorders. It's looking at the locomotives themselves. Okay, it's looking at the track. It's looking at any relationship up there, the operations of the trains, the signal systems, the communications, everything. And it takes quite some time.
Senator Murkowski is saying that this is the third incident involving CSX this month. Can you comment on that at all?
This investigation will be very wide range. Right now, my concern is gathering the facts and the evidence of what occurred here today.
What type of line was it that had the rupture that caused the emergency brake?
That I don't know right now, but we know from the download that we had an emergency application. It was not induced on the front end. It was from the drain line.
What type of line break could
brake? It has to be brake pipe.
In other words, a pipe that controls the brake?
Yes, it's a component. The brake pipe's charged with air. And a break in the brake pipe or a break in the hose causes a rapid discharge of air which triggers the control valves on the braking system. I don't want to get into big details, to go into an emergency application. Sets the brakes on every car.
Did the initial car's derailment cause the other cars to derail and tip over?
I can't really answer that right now until I see more data about how they derailed and what cars and what cars were first off, what cars were.
Did the engineer apply the brakes himself, or did those go off automatically?
The brake application I spoke about was an automatic brake application.
Sir, in terms of progress, what progress you've made from this morning to now in terms of reloading and that kind of thing, the WBAL-TV kind of review, what progress have we made up to this point?
Up to this point, we got our people on the ground here. They've all started to conduct their investigations and gather that multitudinous amount of information I spoke about. Okay, involved in that is downloading information, documenting photographs, video, drawings, digital photography, all kinds of things. That progress is going right now. We've been here all day. We'll be here tomorrow, or be here tonight and probably tomorrow as well.
In terms of uprighting trains, have you done any of that? More than
one of the first things that we did was take the trains that had not derailed and move them away from the accident site for a separate inspection. Okay,
when you say wide-ranging investigation, you look into CX's maintenance.
We'll look into the maintenance of the tracks. We'll look into the maintenance of the equipment, the maintenance of the locomotives, everything you can think of on
so
that
you
thing.
Moved away those trains that were not derailed. What's our percentage?
We moved them away from the derailment site for an inspection that was done on them separately. Okay, so they're not up there. They've been moved. We've looked at the locomotives. They've probably been moved at this time. The rest of the equipment is probably still stationary.
I'm seeing tow trucks and coal. What are they doing with them? Are they reloading them?
I'm not sure where the coal was going, but we had to move the coal to be able to get into some of the areas to look in the parking lot.
Jim, did you say that the brake application was not at the front of the train, but closer to the back?
No, I did not. I do not know where the brake in the train was at this time.
You said it wasn't at the front with the
engine. It wasn't put. The brake application, the emergency application, was not initiated by the locomotive engineer. It was as a result of a break in the brake line and in the train line, in the air brake line, in the train. Don't know at this point where exactly.
Would it be accurate to say that there was a mechanical failure that might
I can't speculate on that right now. It's day one. Still, there's tons of information we have to sift through to be able to make a determination. We haven't ruled anything out yet. I don't know anything about that at this time, and it's just another part of the, another one aspect, one area that we'll look into quite closely.
Sir, can you give me a picture of where this point is and where the train was? There are 80 cars. Where is this roughly? Is this like sort of how far up was the locomotives? If this is this point, how many of the cars were behind and how many cars were ahead?
The first 21 cars of the 80 car train derailed, starting right behind the locomotive. That's what I can tell you.
One more question.
The emergency braking caused the derailment.
No, sir. I didn't say that at all. No, sir. I didn't say that. I did not say that at all.
It preceded.
Don't know that at all. Still have to look at the event recorded data. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.